Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to design and assemble a lathe machine Tailstock. See, the center is going up front side. I hope you will enjoy and we will see how to do each and every part in Solidworks. Here we will design each and every part and at the end we will assemble and we will make little animations how to rotate. See, this is your main part of inside part of Tailstock. When it comes out, see, the hand wheel is rotating. If we will rotate the hand wheel, it will comes out. So let's see how to do in Solidworks. Now here we will sketch the first part of Tailstock body. So let's start. We will select right plane, sketch, draw a horizontal line from origin point. Now exit it, make sure it is horizontal. Sketch two circles. Now just define the dimension 27 mm and 52 mm. Okay, now choose a line. Better define from here to and connect with this circle. Exit. Now let's assign first this vertical line 101 mm. The distance from this line 50.5 mm, 26 mm, and this distance 9 mm. Okay, this one also assign 26 mm. Choose okay. Now select spline. Now we want to connect it from here to this line. Exit. Now select this circle and spline and make relation tangent. Okay, here also the same, make relation tangent. Now it's tangent. Choose trim entities, delete this outer circle and delete this also. Okay, now we will assign some corner radius, or you can say fillet. This corner we will assign 20 mm and this corner 10 mm. Okay, now our geometry is finished. This is your exact requirement. Now select extruded boss and extrude up to 30 mm. Okay, now we will select the raw material, cast carbon steel, and for body I prefer red color. Okay, now first I want to create a plane, so choose this face plane and create one plane 140 mm but reverse direction. Okay, now select this face sketch select convert entities. Now this face is converted, delete this in circle. Okay, so only outer line converted. Now sketch from the exit. Now select this face, sketch. Now what we will do, we will convert some lines. So select this outer lines. That's it. Convert entities. Okay. Now choose a circle and keep the diameter 40 mm. Okay. Now choose a line. Connect it up to circle. Now choose spline and connect with this circle and again make the relation tangent. Delete. Let first assign this relation tangent. Now we will assign this relation as a tangent. I think it's not tangent. Just delete this tangent relation and just adjust, choose trim entity and trim this circle. Okay, now let's try again. Oh, something went wrong. Drag like this. And wherever you satisfied, it's okay. Choose fillet, keep 10 mm and select this end. Okay. Now this is the geometry. Select exit. Exit. Now this is our second geometry. Now choose top plane, sketch. Normal, choose a line and connect from up to this geometry. Exit, select one more line. No, this time select style spline. Connect with this line and exit. Choose here hidden line. Now these are the circles. Select axis. Okay, we can see it here. Choose center line and draw a line from origin point to this line. Exit. Now define the distance from this point to this point, 20 mm. Okay. Now select exit. Now just hide this plane. Now choose lofted boss base and select first sketch, second sketch, select this all, select OK. Then for path, select first this path. Okay, this is open group. Now see, the another path is not selected. So choose this another path. Choose here open group. Now see, this is our second path, open group. Here no need to define anything. Merge tangent faces, select OK. Now see, our face is created. Now select this face, sketch, normal. Select this circle, convert entities. Now again I want to make one more circle. Keep the diameter 42 mm. Okay, and select extruded boss and extrude up to 32.5 mm. Okay, now select this extruded part and assign the raw material brushed finish steel. Side also should be brushed finish. Okay, now select inside face, sketch, normal. Select this circle, convert entity, and choose extruded cut. We want to create a hole through end, so choose up to next. Select okay. Now see, the hole is created. I will select fillet 5 mm and select this end. Okay, that's it. Now choose top plane, sketch, normal. Now here we want to cut something, so let's choose line. Select this face, and connect with this point. Now exit. Now let's assign the distance from here to end point 45 mm, and the distance from outer line keep 105 mm, and this distance 5 mm, and the distance from top line 1st select this line and make relation horizontal. Now assign or better choose corner point. Maybe some relation selected here. Okay, delete this tangent, this coincident relation. Okay, now define this point 7 mm, and define the angle 50.37 mm. That's it. Okay, now select extruded cut and choose through all both. Okay, now see this cutout. Now select this back surface and assign the material brushed finish. Back surface always a steel finish. Now select this face, sketch one plane, and keep distance 125 mm, and but select flip reverse direction. Okay, now select this face, sketch, normal. Now choose this outer circle and select convert entities. the line. And draw one line up to bottom. And go back here and draw a circle. And meet this point. And make relation tangent. I think just delete this relation tangent. Choose three arc point, collect this point to this point, exit. Just take it down little. Just drag it up a small. Better delete this circle and choose 3-point arc and exit. Delete this also and choose spline and connect with this point. Exit. Now here we will assign some relation tangent. Okay, this looking quite better. Just take little down. So it's become a sharp edge. Here no dimension, it's because it's not usable. So just select extruded cut and choose up to next. Select OK. Now see, this portion is cut it. Now select this face, sketch, normal. Select circle and draw a circle and select this point. Exit from the circle. Now keep the distance between these two 0.6. Okay. Now choose a line. Okay, again choose a line, come down and here connect where these two joints are connected. Now exit. Okay, now we will assign some distance from origin point, 30 mm. Okay, now this one you can move little up. Okay, that's okay. Now select extruded cut and here select this face and this face also inside. Two faces. We want to cut up to 26.5 and the angle keep 1 degree. Select OK. Now see. Now choose fillet. Select 40 mm. Choose this inside. OK. Now again choose fillet. Keep 5 mm. And this time select this circular part inside. Okay. Now hide this plane. Now here select top plane, sketch, normal. Choose a line. Connect. Now exit. Now select this outer line and this line, make sure this line parallel. Now select this line and this outer line and make sure parallel. Okay. Now select this line and this outer line and make relation collinear. Okay, now choose distance 10 mm, and the distance here from this point 26 mm. Okay, just go back one step. Delete this distance. First assign this outer line and this distance 13 mm. Okay, now select this line. It is collinear but not perpendicular. Now select this line and make relation horizontal. Okay. Select this point and this point. Now this distance make 26 mm. Select OK. Now choose fillet. Keep 10 mm and select all four corners. Select OK. Now select this line and delete this collinear method. Now choose this line and this line. We want to make some distance. Make 26 mm. Okay. Now all the circles are defined. So now select extruded cut. Downward bottom side. Keep 35 mm and direction 2. Upward direction more. Select more. Okay. Now see, we selected, we make cutouts. Now choose fillet, keep 10 mm and select this inside face. Okay. Now again choose top plane, sketch, normal, select line and start from here. Exit. Choose again line. select 3-point arc and connect this end to this end. Now connect this end to this end. Now let's assign the dimension. First make one center line. Now let's assign the dimension. (13 mm) (22.5 mm). This distance from outside 48 mm. Okay. Now this line from this line 5 mm. The same this line from this line. Keep 15 mm, 13 mm, keep 3.5 mm. Okay, and select this end point and this end point, same line horizontal. Now this radius assigned (153). Okay, now choose fillet, keep 2 mm, select this two ends. Okay, now choose 5 mm and select these two ends. Okay. Now we will do one thing. Select sketch and extend it, then connect. Now this inside line select geometry, construction geometry. Now we will select extruded cut. Full throughout body, choose mid plane, select OK. Now that's it. Now again choose this, select this face sketch, select this plane and click convert entities. Choose normal, select a line and connect from this end to this end. Now exit, choose trim entities, trim these two lines. Okay, select corner rectangle and draw a rectangle. And select this point and this line coincident. Delete. We will connect it. Exit. Now choose trim entity and trim this and this line also. Okay, because it is taper, not horizontal position. Now select smart dimension 3.5 mm, length 32 mm. Okay, now choose circle and draw one circle here and keep the distance from upper line 6 mm and the diameter 7.94 mm and the distance from here to last end 90.5 mm. Select OK. Now choose center line, connect from this midpoint. Exit. Now select this center line and make relation vertical. Okay. Now select extruded boss. Make reverse direction. Keep 21 mm inside. Okay. Now choose cosmetic thread. Select this line. Here choose inch, machine thread. 3x8, 16 inch up to next. Okay. Go to option documents property detailing and click here cosmetic thread. Okay. Refresh. Now see, you can see your cosmetic thread here. Now select top plane, choose mirror and select the last extruded body. Okay. Now it is extruded here. See. Now select this inside face, this sketch normal. Select, this is the origin point. Okay. Draw a circle and draw one circle from midpoint to this point. Select this line and make relation vertical. Again choose circle and draw one more circle. Now keep the diameter 25 mm and the inside diameter 11 mm. Okay. Now make sure this origin point and this point in same horizontal position. Okay. This is the very important relation. Now select extruded boss. Keep 20 mm reverse direction, upward direction, and go to direction 2 and only 2 mm outside. Okay. Now select this inside face sketch and select convert entity. Now this hole is converted and choose extruded cut and here select up to next. We want to create a hole, so okay. Now you can see the hole is created. Okay. Now select front plane, sketch, normal. Choose circle and draw one circle here. Draw one center line also. Now assign the distance from center line 23 mm, diameter 12 mm, and the distance from outer line 6 mm. Okay. Now select extruded boss. Now here it's going to extrude up to 20 mm. Okay. Choose chamfer 3 mm and select this edge. Okay. Now select this face sketch normal and draw a circle here. Keep the diameter 39 mm. Okay. And select here helix and spiral. We are going to create some thread in this portion. Choose pitch and revolution, constant pitch, and this pitch select only 4, and revolution, reverse direction, revolution 7.75, 270 degree clockwise. Okay, now again choose front plane sketch, select here corner rectangle and draw one corner rectangle from this corner point. Now let's assign the length 1.5 and the height length also 1.75 mm and height 1.5 mm. Okay. Now exit. Now here select swift cut. Profile selected, just select here path. So this is the path. Select, follow the path. Okay. Now it's calculating. Now see, this one assign brush steel. Now again choose this thread created, front plane sketch, select a line, connect with this point. Now let's assign the dimension 10.5 mm and keep the angle 20 degree. Okay. Choose center line and draw one center line. Make sure it is horizontal. Okay. Now select revolve cut. We want to make some chamfer here. Okay. Brushed finish. Okay. Now again choose top plane sketch, exit, select front plane sketch. Okay, that's it. First draw a center line, center line of this, exit. Now choose offset entities. Select 0.75 mm and select this center line and keep here bidirectional. Cancel it. Better draw a line. First draw a circle. Connect with this point. Keep the diameter 2.5 mm. Now select circle and connect with. Now let's assign the gap between circle and this point 0.75 mm. Okay, just mirror this line against construction line. Okay. Now close from one end. Okay. Now here choose trim entity and trim this inside lines. Okay. Now we want to select extruded cut. Select here through all. Through all both direction. Okay. See this thread cutout created. Now select this cutout and choose circular pattern. Select this outer circle. We want two numbers only. And here select degree 90. No need equal spacing. Okay. Now select this last two cutouts. and make this brushed finished steel. That's it. Now select this face, normal, and go to hole wizard, and here we want to create some straight tap. So select straight tap, choose here metric, tapped hole, M6 by 1. Depth I want 25 mm, thread 24. Now choose position. Just select this and the center point select. Select here OK. See the threads, cosmetic thread you can see inside. OK. Now again choose front plane, sketch, and here we want to create one, choose center rectangle. Okay, now assign the dimension 5 by 5 mm and the distance from outer line 6.5 mm. Okay, select center line and select this center point and this whole point. Select this construction line and make relation horizontal. Okay, now select extruded cut. Now see, now here we want to create some relation. So select here offset from surface, select this surface and offset from surface, keep 15 mm, because 15 mm depth we want. Okay, this depth also should be polished finished. So this is the our body, just hide origin point. Now this is the body of Tailstock. You can see it here. Now we will save it. Go to desktop, create one folder and select Tailstock. Open. And select, this is the first part. Body. Save. Now let's move for the next part. Now we forget to add some holes to tap fillet. Select this 2 mm. Again choose fillet. Keep 0.5 mm. And select this end. Okay. Now select the top face and inside face and make brushed steel the same as this bottom face, also should be brushed steel. Okay, now it is updated. Save it. Let's move for next part. Now the next part we will sketch Morse taper. This tool holds the machine tool inside the machine spindle. So let's start. Choose front plane, sketch. First draw a central horizontal center line. Make sure it is horizontal. Now select a line. and connect this point. Now exit. Now select this point and this line. Actually it should be, relation should be like both in vertical position. Now let's assign the distance 156 mm. The distance from here to here 65 mm, 12 mm, and distance from this line, choose mid distance 11.5 mm, this distance 14.5 mm, and this distance 17.8 mm. Now this distance from center line, mid distance keep 27 mm, and this one change it up to 20 mm. Okay, now choose revolve boss base, center line selected. Okay, choose chamfer 1.5 mm and select this end. Okay, now we want to create some thread here. Select this face sketch, select this inside line, convert entities. Now choose helix and spiral, pitch and revolution, constant pitch. Pitch select 2.5 mm, reverse direction 8 mm, and 8 number of revolution, and 270 degree start angle clockwise. Okay, now again choose front plane sketch normal, choose a line here, select connect with this point, again choose a center line. Now select these three lines and make relation symmetric. Okay, now let's assign angle 59 degree, 2.8 mm the length, keep 1.5 mm, and this distance 0.81 mm. Okay, now select this line and this line, make collinear. Okay, now exit from the sketch and select sweep cut. Profile selected, just select this path. See the threads going to cut in from inside. Okay, see the threads cut inside. Now select this face sketch, draw a center line up to top. Select corner rectangle. Okay, now select these three lines and make relation symmetric. Okay, keep keep the length 5 mm. And height 2.8. Okay. Now select this line and this point coincide. Okay. Now select extruded cut and choose here up to next. Select OK. We will assign satin finish stainless steel. Now save as part number 2, Morse taper tool. Save. Okay, so let's move for the next part. Now the next part is the screw. So choose front plane, sketch, select line, draw one horizontal line, little up, connect. Now let's assign the distance. Select overall length 147. five mm. nine point five mm, 4.5 mm, and this length 6.5 mm, and this length keep 5 mm. Okay. Now let's assign the dimension. Four mm, 47 mm, 9 mm, 5 mm, and 3 mm. Now our geometry is fully defined. See. Now select revolve boss base. Select this bottom line as a axis. Okay. Now we will sketch some thread. So select this face, sketch. Select this circle and convert it. Now helical and spiral. And we want to create some thread here. So choose constant pitch. Pitch select 2.5 reverse direction. And revolution 33.5, okay, 270 degree and counterclockwise. Okay. Now select front plane, sketch. Now here we will draw a profile. Exit. Draw a center line. Now select these three lines and make relation symmetric. Now let's assign the angle 29 degree. and the height 1.5 mm and 0.8 mm is the pitch. Okay. Now select this outer line and this line. Make relation collinear. Okay. Now exit from the sketch. Select here swift cut profile selector. Just select this path. Select OK. Let's edit this sketch normal and do one thing, just drag this here. Okay, and exit. It will calculate again, it takes few seconds. Be patient. Now see, our threads are created. Now select top plane sketch and here I want to create some hole. And keep the diameter 4 mm and the distance from outer line 20 mm. Okay. Draw a center line and make sure center line and this one in horizontal position. Now select extruded cut and choose here through all both. See the thread hole going to create. It's taking time. Maybe due to calculation. Now I want to do some domes here. Go to insert feature and select dome. And here select 2 mm and select this face. See this small dome I want to create. Okay. It's taking time. Okay. Now just assign the material. Brush finish steel. So this is the screw for Tailstock. We will see how to do in assembly. Select 0.3 screw. Now save. Okay, let's move for the next part. Now we will sketch the next part, crank wheel. So choose front plane. Select. Start from origin point. Go back and draw a circle or just exit. Assign center point and draw a half circle. Exit. Now choose three arc point, select this Okay. Now take it down. Now assign the relation tangent. Okay. Now let's assign the dimension. The distance from here to origin point 24 mm. Three mm, 7 mm, and the diameter or radius you can say 5.5 mm. Okay. Now select this point and this point and make relation horizontal. Okay. Now this radius assign 24 mm. Okay. Choose trim entity and trim this inside line. Okay. Now select revolve boss base. Select bottom line as a axis. Okay. Now insert some cosmetic thread. Select this outer line. Choose metric. Machine thread 6 by 1 inch and depth up to blind 7 mm. Okay. Go to option detailing and click here shaded cosmetic thread. Okay. Assign chrome plating. See, this is the beautiful crank wheel. Now save as part number 4 crank wheel. Save. Let's move for the next part. Now the next part is wheel. So start from front plane sketch. Select a line and start our geometry. Better first select a center line. Now just above the origin point, just go back and draw a quarter circle. Here also come back and draw a quarter circle. Little move. Exit. Now choose a line, make little up, select 3-point arc, connect these 2 points, make relation tangent. Make sure this one horizontal. Now let's assign the distance. Five point five mm. Keep 9 mm. Select 3 mm. This radius also keep 3 mm. 3 mm. And the distance from here to this point 11 mm. And make the radius 24 mm. This also select 2.5 mm. Now assign this distance 15 mm. Now overall length 1.76, or delete this length. Now define 24 mm. So this is the our geometry. Now select revolve boss base. This mid cent construction line selected as a axis. Okay. Again choose front plane sketch normal. Now draw a circle. Keep the diameter 15 mm and the distance from delete it and draw one line from mid. Okay, now let's assign the distance between these two lines. Keep 5 mm and the distance from origin point (75/2 mm). That's it. Okay, first draw a horizontal line. Make sure it is horizontal. Now choose revolve boss base. Select OK. Now see. Now again choose front plane sketch normal. And here select 2D axis. Choose a line. Connect from this point to this point. Exit. Now exit from the sketch. Now we want to create one plane here. So select this line, choose plane, and select this bottom line. See, plane going to create. Okay, now select this plane sketch normal. So this is the center point. So select just center point straight slot. Select the line, make relation vertical. Select this line and center point. Okay, this slot created. Let's assign the distance. Keep 5 mm. Radius 2.5 mm. Select OK. Now select extruded boss. Select here up to next and go to direction 2 up to next. Select OK. Now hide this plane. Now select circular pattern. Select this extruded body and select this center line. Select 360 degree, equal spacing 360 degree, and select 3 numbers. OK. Now see, now choose top plane, sketch, normal, and here I want to create one circle and keep the diameter 4 mm. Select hidden line visible. OK. Now assign the distance from this outer line. Make it 20 mm. OK. Now make one more relation horizontal. Now select extruded cut. Choose here through all both. Not through all both. We will choose mid plane and just we will extrude it little. Okay, that's it. Okay. Now see, the hole is created. Now you can hide this sketch. Now we want to create some choose hole wizard. Select straight tap, metric, tapped hole, M6 by 1, and here choose blind 7. Go to position, select 3D sketch. Select any one position. See, it is selected. OK. Go to option. Detailing and select here shaded cosmetic thread. See the cosmetic thread created here. Now select the whole body and assign the material chrome finish. See the beautiful chrome finish material. Now save this part wheel. Let's move for the next part. Now here we will make the handle knob. So choose front plane. Select a full circle. Select line and connect it from one end to another end. Choose trim entity and delete half circle. Now let's assign the diameter. Radius keep 15 mm. Okay, now select revolve boss base. This line select as a axis. Okay, now select hole wizard. Choose straight tap, metric, M10 by 1.5 mm, blind length 13.5 and thread up to 6 mm. Go to position, select 3D sketch. Select this point, center point, and any point select. See this center point and this selected. Select OK. Now you can see. Go to unit option, detailing, shaded cosmetic thread. Now you can see the cosmetic threads. You can see, just go to, we will assign some copper. This is the knob, brushed copper. Now save as part number 6 knob. Let's go for next. Now the next part is knob handle. Handle for Tailstock. Choose front plane. Select line. And start from one end, origin point. Draw a horizontal line. Connected. Now this is the geometry, and let's assign the dimension. Mm, assign 2 mm, and the distance from this point 5 mm, 5 mm, 7 mm. And this length 6 mm, and the length from this point to this point 60 mm, 10 mm, and select this height 7 mm. Now our geometry is fully defined. Choose fillet. Keep 2 mm and select this line and choose this line. Keep 2 mm. Okay, later we will design. Select this bottom line as a axis. Okay. Keep fillet 2 mm radius, or select small 1.5 mm. Now we will assign some cosmetic thread. Select one end. Here select M8 by 1, blind 6 mm. Keep blind 10 mm. Okay. Again go to insert, annotation, cosmetic thread, metric, machine thread, and here select M10 by 1.25 mm and blind 6 mm. Select this end. Okay. Now go to option and always keep select shaded cosmetic thread. Now see, we will assign some material, chrome finish. Now save as part number 7 handle. Let's move for the next part. Now the here next part is Tailstock center. Choose front plane sketch. Now assign the dimension. The overall length is 90 mm. And keep the height 9 mm. This length 5.5 mm, 7.25 mm, and 9 mm. Delete this relation tangent. Now edit 3 mm. Now our 15 mm, 9 mm. Okay. Now our geometry is fully defined. Select revolve boss base and bottom line as a axis. Okay. And here assign chrome finish also, we can assign. Now save this. Part number 8, Tailstock center. Okay, let's move for the next part. Now we will sketch the shaft key or barrel key. Choose front plane, sketch, select corner rectangle and start from origin point and draw a T-shaped geometry. Select this both the line and make relation collinear. Now assign the dimension 12 mm, 3.5 mm, 5 mm, height 2.5 mm, and the overall height 10.5 mm. Okay, this is the key for actually this should be both equal. Okay, now extruded boss and extrude up to only 5 mm. Okay, brush finish. Now save as part number 9, shaft key, save. Let's go for the next part. Now let's make the tailstock bush. Choose front plane. Now start. Select line and start. Better first draw a horizontal line, center line. Just go back and draw a half circle here. Little come down. And connect it. Exit. Select this point and this same line. Same line. This is the relation. Now let's assign the dimension. The overall length 27 mm. The distance from bottom line 5.5 mm. 29.34 by 2 mm, and this point 11 mm. Now this height keep. (1.5 mm). (8 mm). Only 1 mm. Keep radius 4 mm and this radius 7 mm. Now geometry in perfect place. Now the distance from this line to here 20 mm. Okay. Now our geometry is fully defined. Choose revolve boss base. Okay. Now choose cosmetic thread. Choose here inch. Select here 1/8 by 12 and blind length select 8 mm. Select this edge. Okay. Cosmetic thread. That's it. Now choose hole wizard and select hole. I want to make metric 3.5 dia hole and length 12 mm. Select position and choose here 3D sketch. Now select this point. Now you can rotate, it's up to you. Now delete. Now one is enough. So just select OK. Now see, a throughout hole is created. Now this part we will assign some satin finish. This brass. Now save as Part number 10, Tailstock bush. Now the last part is tailstock ram. So choose front plane sketch, select line. Draw one horizontal line. Select this line and choose construction geometry. Okay, now we will assign the dimension. First select overall length 37 mm, 13.5 from bottom line, top line 24.5 mm. Now this bottom line (19.5 mm) and this point 20 mm, and this length 3 mm. Okay, now select this point and this point vertical. Okay, now assign the distance. Keep 11 mm. Okay, now our geometry is fully defined. Select revolve boss base. Okay, choose chamfer 3 mm, select inside circle. Okay, now select this outer face sketch, select this inside circle and convert it. Okay, and I want to create some thread here, so first we will select some spiral path, pitch and revolution, constant pitch, pitch keep 4 mm, reverse direction and revolution 5.75 mm, start angle 270 degree and counterclockwise. Okay, now again choose front plane or select top plane sketch normal. Exit, better choose front plane sketch normal. Now select line, and start to draw our geometry. Choose this X. Okay, line selected. Now we will start from this point. and here select center line. Select these three line and make relation symmetric. Okay, and now assign degree 29 mm and the length 2.5 mm and this height keep 1.35 mm. That's it. Now exit from the geometry. Now choose swift cut. Profile selected, just select this path. Okay. Now see the threads is created. Now choose top plane. Plane and keep the distance 30.5 mm. Okay, now select this plane, sketch normal. And here draw a circle. Keep the diameter 40 mm and the distance from corner edge 11 mm. And make sure it is in same line. Select extruded boss and select here up to surface. And select this surface. Okay. Now select this face, choose hole wizard, select straight tap, 10 by 1.5 inch matrix, and the length 5 and this one 3.5. Now select position, just find out the midpoint of this circle, select OK. Now just click shaded thread. Now see the shaded thread looking inside. Now hide this plane. And assign the material satin finish stainless steel. Okay. Now save this part. Tailstock RAM. Okay. Let's start the assembly of Tailstock. Now the one more part is balance for Tailstock pin. So choose front plane, sketch, select circle and draw a circle with 4 mm diameter. And select extruded boss and extrude up to 28 mm. Okay. Now save as part number 12 pin. material color, we will apply something else so it will easily identify. Okay. Now let's start the assembly. Now we are going to start the assembly of Tailstock. So choose new assembly. Okay. Now assembly window open. So browse our first part body. And let's do some setting, plain white, and image quality also I'll prefer high. So it looks very sharp edge. Okay. Now browse the parts, select shafty. Now just rotate it, make like this. Take inside. Choose mat. Go to advanced mat, select width. Now select this face and opposite face. Now go down and here also same this face and just go to opposite direction and select this face. Now see it is in parallel position. Again we want to create one more relation. Select this another side wall and this side wall and make relation standard mat coincident. Okay, just take it down. See the it's going inside the hole. Select this hollow shell and this edge and make relation coincident. Okay, now the shaft key is fixed. Now we will browse the next part, screw. Just rotate this and browse one more part, Morse taper tool. Okay, first fix this one, choose this upper or inside hole mat and body. Okay, just edit this. Select here reverse align because keep remember this thread should be back side, not front side. See these threads. Select OK. Now make one relation with this key. Select the wall of key and the inside wall, make relation parallel. Okay. Now select this outer face and this face, make relation concentric. Okay. Now just take it out. And we will create one best relation screw. Keep distance 1. Select this face. And select this screw face. Make distance revolution 1 mm. Select OK. OK. Now after creating this screw relation, we will fix any one part so that another part will rotate. So we will do one thing. Browse the another component. I'll prefer to bring tailstock bush. Rotate this bush. Keep this one here. Okay. Now select mat. Select this surface and inside. And make relation concentric. Okay. We will create a relation between these two bodies. Select this backspace and this face concentric. Okay. Now this relation created. Now just move it. Watch carefully. Now select this face and select this face coincident. Okay. Now browse the another component, hand wheel. Okay. Now just rotate the hand wheel. Select okay. Choose mat and select this screw and this hole and make relation concentric. Just drag it out and here one more relation. Select this hole and this hole concentric. Okay. Okay. Now insert the next component, pin. Select this pin, mat, and select this hole. Now just put it inside. Now select this face and choose lock. Clear. Wheel. Select the plane of wheel. The front plane of wheel, top plane of wheel, and select front plane of we do one thing. Okay. Press control key and choose front plane of key. Select mat. Make relation parallel. I think this is not sufficient. So do one thing, just select pin, edit part, and here select modify edit and choose here mid plane. That's it. Now our problem solved. Now save as, cancel, save in assembly, yes. Now assign the relation. Choose the top plane of a hand wheel and for pin press control key and select front plane and select mat. Now it is coincident. Now this pin in center of the wheel, select OK. OK. Now see it is rotating. Insert the another component, crank hand wheel. select this face inside hole mat and this OK. Select this hand wheel and select the backspace. Make relation tangent. OK. Now the hand wheel hand is fixed. Now see hide just make the transparent. Now we will show, just rotate this, see the threads rotating inside. If we push out this bar, see the threads rotating means our screw is fixed. Okay, now insert some more component. Browse the another component, Tailstock RAM. Okay, just select the body and change transparency. That's it. Now rotate it first. Okay, now first make concentric relation, so choose mat, select this circular face and this circular face, concentric mat. Okay, now select this body face and this face. Okay, now it is coincident here. Now the next component is handle. Select this inside hole mat, reverse direction. Okay, now select this face and this face, coincident. Okay, now this relation created. Now we will bring our knob, handle knob. I think we put it some wrong relations, so last two relations just delete it. Yes, now remove it and rotate it. It is actually reverse. This thread is actually for this thread. Now choose mat, concentric. Now select bottom face and upper face. Okay, now see it is perfectly matched. Now here also just first rotate the knob. Okay, now choose mat. Select this thread and inside the hole of knob. Okay, now press this face and knob. Make relation tangent. Okay, now the knob and handle everything fix here. Now let's see what else balance. I think this all part fixed. Tailstock center. Just rotate first component. Okay. Choose mat. Select this face and this corner edge. Coincident. Okay. Now the tailstock center is fixed with bush. Now our, let's see if any part balance or no. Pin also fixed. This all part I think fixed. Nothing is balanced. Okay. Now cancel it. So this is the our tailstock, lathe tailstock. See, it looks, if it looks a very nice, see. See, it is rotating. This ram is rotating around the, this is the center for supporting any component in lathe machine. And this is the our handle. See, if we are rotating this tailstock going inside dead center, now just rotate it and see, is coming out. So this is the beautiful tailstock of lathe machine. First save our assembly. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe our channel and like this video, and don't forget to share this video. I hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe and make comments. If you have any question related to this, please ask, don't hesitate. Thanks for watching. Now we will try some animation for this. Right click here, motion manager, go to motion manager, extrude the assembly up to 6 mm, select option, select 30 mm, and choose motor. Select this face, select 80 mm, make sure rotary motion selected, OK. Now press down and select here calculate. We want to edit motor. Select this reverse direction. Okay. Now again choose recalculate. See, the handle is rotating. Now see, it's going reverse from this point to here. It will now see tailstock coming out. Now just see the tailstock going inside, and now it will come up outside. So this is the beautiful tailstock. I hope you understand. Please subscribe and don't forget to share and like our video. Thanks for watching.